In order for a chemical equation to be balanced, there must be the same numbers of each atom on both sides of the equation. Now, in order to balance a chemical equation, you're going to have to do some tweaking to the amounts of atoms on both sides. And so there's some rules and guidelines to follow. So first, don't touch the subscripts. Instead, you're going to balance by adjusting the coefficients of each formula. Then balance the different atoms one at a time. So balance one atom, then move on to the next. Balance atoms that appear only once on each side. Balance polyatomic atoms as units. In many cases, balance hydrogen and oxygen atoms after others have been balanced. Make sure the coefficients are in the simplest ratios. So in other words, if you had a coefficient of 4 on one side of the equation and a coefficient of 2 on the other side of the equation, you could reduce those coefficients to be 2 and 1. So we have this equation right here with nitrogen and hydrogen reacting together to form a product, and it's unbalanced because right now we have 2 nitrogen atoms here and only 1 here. We have 2 hydrogen atoms here and 3 on the right side. So starting off, we can't touch the subscripts, so instead we're going to have to touch the coefficients. Now, we need to figure out which one to start with. Well, remember, we're supposed to balance hydrogen and oxygen atoms after others have been balanced. So we're going to start with nitrogen. So if we have 2 over here, the simplest thing to do is add a coefficient of 2 right here to make that nitrogen even. So now that we have balanced one atom, then we can move on to the next, which is hydrogen. So with the coefficient of 2 and the subscript of 3, there's 6 hydrogen atoms on the product side. So we need to get 6 total on the left side here. So we're going to do that by adding coefficient of 3. Now the important thing to do is go back and check your work. So we have 2 nitrogen atoms here, 2 here, we have 6 here, and 6 here. So this chemical equation is balanced.